nutrition in human beings. Food enters our body through mouth and travels through a long canal which ends at anus. This canal is called alimentary canal. In the mouth, the food is ground to a paste by teeth and saliva. Saliva is a watery fluid, not only makes the food soft and wet, it also has an enzyme called salivary amylase which partially digests the sugars. Now, the food has to reach the stomach through a pipe called esophagus. The muscles of the esophagus contract rhythmically to move the food through it into the stomach. Stomach is a large muscular hollow organ in which the food is thoroughly mixed with more digestive juices secreted by gastric glands present in the walls of the stomach. These juices include 1. Pepsin, a protein digesting enzyme, 2. Hydrochloric acid, to provide acidic medium for the proper action of pepsin, and 3. Mucus, to prevent the damage of stomach wall by the action of HCl. At the end of the stomach, a sphincter muscle slowly releases the food into the small intestine, the longest part of the alimentary canal, which is highly coiled to get accommodated in small space. It receives pancreatic juice from the pancreas, intestinal juices from the glands in the intestines, and bile juice from the liver. Pancreatic juice and intestinal juices contain enzymes like trypsin, lipase, pancreatic amylase, peptidases, and nucleases. Bile does two things. 1. It breaks the fats into smaller droplets, providing more surface area for the quick action of enzymes. 2. Bile makes the intestinal pH to alkaline, so by that the digestion of fats and carbohydrates is facilitated. These enzymes finally make the carbohydrates to sugars, proteins to amino acids, and fats to fatty acids and glycerol. The inner lining of the small intestine has finger-like projections called villi, where the nutrients derived in digestion are absorbed into the bloodstream. The unabsorbed food is sent into a large intestine where water is absorbed and the rest is excreted out through anus.